Thank you for letting me be here tonight. My name is Frank Simpson. I have Senate District 14, which is Love, Carter, Murray, and most of Johnston County. I live just north of Ardmore. The biggest town in my district is Ardmore, Oklahoma, and the biggest town in Josh's district is Durant, Oklahoma. And Durant and Ardmore compete in a lot of things. We compete against each other in football, compete against each other for economic development. But one thing we have in common is the Arbuckle-Simpson Aquifer. Without the Arbuckle-Simpson Aquifer, Ardmore nor Durant would exist on planet Earth because of our dependence upon the Arbuckle-Simpson as our source of drinking water. We won a tremendous victory a couple of weeks ago where the Oklahoma County District Court ruled in favor of the Citizens for the Protection of the Arbuckle-Simpson, ruled that the equal proportionate share as established by the Water Resource Board was valid, was based upon good science. Circling around that court decision, I noticed one thing has happened over the last couple of years, and I've learned more about water the last 5 years than ever knew there was to learn, and I learned so much from Earl Brewer, and God bless Earl Brewer, who we lost earlier this year. Earl Brewer was a tremendous mentor for me and for Charles, and he really educated us a lot on the water issue, and I miss Earl tremendously. But we've seen the faces change in the water battle. Those that were one time our advocates are now our adversaries. And I'm talking about the Farm Bureau. The Farm Bureau sued the citizens of Southern Oklahoma to try to capture the water from the Arbuckle-Simpson Aquifer. Farm Bureau is now changing its position, the strong position that they held for years to protect property rights. Today, they passed out of their resolutions committee the withdrawal of their opposition to the use of eminent domain to build infrastructure to transport water out of the state. Farm Bureau has always been an advocate of property rights. Now they are no longer going to object to the use of eminent domain to take your property to ship your water to Texas. They are no longer going to be opposed to the out-of-state sale of water. Farm Bureau now, who at one time was a grassroots organization, represented us well here in Southern Oklahoma, is now aligning themselves with corporate interests in Oklahoma City, to our detriment. In 2002, I think it was, when they wanted to draw water out of the Arbuckle-Simpson, they wanted to draw a tremendous amount of water. And based upon that consumption, if 2003 had not seen the passage of Senate Bill 288, which mandated, would put a moratorium on the withdrawal of water from the aquifer and mandated a hydrological study of the aquifer, if that water had been drawn from the aquifer, it would be dry today. We would not be here because we would have no water to sustain our survival. They say, well, we need water in Oklahoma City for our economic growth. What about our economic growth down here? It's our water. They say they need water in Oklahoma City for domestic use. What about us? We need water for domestic use too to grow our population. So we've got to be aware of those who we thought were our friends at one time are no longer our friends when it comes to the water issue. We are in this fight to win it. We won the first round of the battle with the court decision protecting the Arbuckle-Simpson and establishing the maximum annual yield as established by research. But we've got to keep our eye on the ball because we have a lot of enemies out there, a lot of adversaries whose only goal is to take our water for their benefit, and they will exploit us without blinking an eye. It's a pleasure to be here with you tonight, and I've got some cards here too. If you ever have any questions, need any assistance on any issues, even though you're not in my district, Senator Silk will work together. We're here to protect valuable resource, resource that's going to guarantee future generations in Oklahoma. And that's the thing we've got to remember. Thank you.